which is about the young and for the young. Besides, our narrator, that is the person who will tell you the story as we go along, is 9 years old, count them, which more than makes up for my advanced age. Her name is Miss Alexandra Wager, and she is an actress who is rapidly becoming very well known. Alexandra. Everything all right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, usually before this piece begins, the narrator is supposed to explain how each person or animal in the story is described by a certain instrument of the orchestra. But of course, you're all so sophisticated, I'm sure you know all that already. You're such musical experts by now. At least I hope you are. I see some doubtful faces. How about let's try you out? Let's just see. Do you know what character these three horns represent? Say it. Right. Oh, yes, I can see. You do know it. What is this oboe? Right, the duck. Right again. And now what about the flute? You're batting 1,000. The bird, right. Now who's this low character in the clarinet? The cat. I didn't have to play more than 3 notes of that one. Then there are those famous drum beats. Cut. Cut. What did you say? Right. The hunters shooting their guns. And what's that lumbering old? I won't tell you the instrument because that'll give it away. Right, the grandfather, and the instrument is the bassoon. My, you really do know this piece, don't you? Well, that's all of them. Except, wait, I left out the most important one, didn't I? Absolutely correct. And now, Miss Wager, it is your show.
One morning, Peter opened the gate and went in a big green meadow. Of a big tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend. All is quiet, chirped the little bird gaily.
Just then, a duck came waddling around. Oh, she was so glad that Peter had not closed the gate behind him and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow.
Thank you.
Seeing the duck, the little bird flew down upon the grass, settled next to her, and shrugged his shoulders. "Now, what kind of a bird are you if you can't fly?" said he. To this the duck replied, "What kind of a bird are you if you can't swim?" and dived into the pond. They argued and argued, the duck swimming in the pond, the little bird hopping along the shore. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. He noticed a cat crawling through the grass. "Aha," thought the cat, "the bird is busy arguing. I'll just grab him." So quietly she crept towards him on her velvet paws. "Look out," cried Peter, and the bird immediately flew up into the tree. While the duck quacked angrily at the cat. From the middle of the pond. The cat walked round and round the tree and thought to himself, "Is it worth climbing up so high? Well, by the time I get there, the bird will have flown away."
While Peter was watching the cat make up her mind, he suddenly saw his grandfather standing at the open gate. Grandfather was very angry because Peter had gone out into the meadow. "This is a dangerous place," he growled. "Suppose a wolf came out of the forest, then what would you do?" Peter paid no attention to his grandfather's words because boys like Peter aren't afraid of wolves. Grandfather took Peter firmly by the hand, led him home, and locked the gate.
Thank you.
No sooner had Peter gone than a big gray wolf came out of the forest.
Flash, the cat scampered up the tree. Duck's quacking became even louder than before, and in her excitement, she jumped right out of the pond. But no matter how fast the duck tried to waddle away, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer and nearer, catching up with her. And bang, he got her, and with one gulp, he swallowed her. Now, this is how the situation was. The cat was sitting on one branch of the big tree. And the bird on another branch. Not too close to the cat.
Meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate, watching all that was going on. He ran home, got a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall. Now, one of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was walking stretched out over the wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter lightly climbed onto the tree. Then Peter said to the bird, "Now listen, bird, fly down and circle around the wolf's head. Only take care that he doesn't catch you."
Oh, how the bird did tease that wolf. and how the wolf wanted to catch that bird. But the bird was cleverer, and the wolf simply couldn't do a thing about it. Meanwhile, Peter had been making a lasso out of the rope, and now he carefully began letting it down. And down. And down. Until he caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. The moment the wolf felt his tail caught in the lasso, he became furious and began to jump about wildly, trying to get loose. Tied the other end of the rope to the branch. Just then, Peter saw some hunters coming out of the woods. They had been following the wolf's trail, and they were shooting as they came. Peter, high up in the tree, shouted to the hunters, "Don't shoot! The bird and I have already caught the wolf. All you have to do is help us take him to the zoo." There's the story. And now, just imagine the victory parade. Peter, of course, in the lead. Thank you. Following Peter, the hunters leading the wolf. Winding up the whole parade, Grandfather and the Cat. Grandfather, of course, was pretty grumpy about the whole thing. Well, he said, and what if Peter hadn't caught the wolf? What then? Above them all flew the little bird, chirping merrily, "My, what fine fellows we are, Peter and I. Look what we have caught, a whole wolf." Listen very carefully, you can still hear the duck quacking, very softly, of course, inside the wolf's belly. Because the wolf, in all his excitement and hurry, swallowed her alive.